While the practice of fasting has been around for centuries, its popularity is on the rise, and people are turning to it for its many health benefits, including weight loss, the reduction of type 2 diabetes, and inflammation. But does fasting really work, and how? Well, here's what the science says. Fasting is essentially abstaining from some or all foods for a period of time. Under normal conditions, without fasting, the body's primary and most readily available source of fuel is glucose. And after food intake, insulin levels rise to facilitate the uptake of glucose into the bodily tissues and cells where it can be used for energy. Excess glucose not needed for immediate energy is then converted to glycogen, and it's stored in the liver and muscles, and triglycerides are stored in adipose tissue. When fasting, insulin levels decline and stored glycogen is converted back to glucose for energy. When glycogen stores are depleted, the body will then undergo a process called gluconeogenesis, where excess amino acids are converted to glucose by the liver, which is part of a process called autophagy. When energy demands exceed the production of glucose via gluconeogenesis, the body will turn to fat as its primary source of fuel, a state also known as ketosis. The metabolic and hormonal changes induced by fasting include, but are not limited to, decreased insulin levels, improved insulin sensitivity, increased growth hormone, increased noradrenaline secretion, and increased metabolic efficiency. Research has shown the benefits of fasting include improvements in body composition, athletic performance, cognitive function, immune function, microbiome composition, and longevity. So now that we've discussed how fasting works, let's discuss the various types of fasting. First, there's intermittent fasting, perhaps the most well-known fasting method today. Intermittent fasting typically involves a daily eating window of 8 to 10 hours, followed by a 14 to 16 hour of fasting. Intermittent fasting encompasses a number of different types of fasting, including time-restricted eating, 16-8 fasting, and the 5-2 diet. Time-restricted eating, as the name implies, this type of fasting involves restricting food consumption for a period of time, usually 12 to 16 hours, fairly easy to implement because fasting can take place overnight. For example, if you finished your last meal at 6 p.m., you would plan to have breakfast between 6 a.m. and 10 a.m. the next day. 16-8 intermittent fasting involves eating for 8 hours of the day, followed by 16 hours of fasting. And the 5-2 intermittent fasting diet involves eating normally for 5 consecutive days, then limiting caloric intake to about 500 to 600 calories per day for 2 days a week. Then there's the fasting mimicking diet. This is a meal program developed by Dr. Walter Longo, meant to mimic the effects of fasting. It involves restricted caloric intake for 5 consecutive days out of the month, followed by a return to regular eating for the rest of the month. We all have heard of the Master Cleanse. The Master Cleanse, also known as the Lemonade Diet, is a modified juice cleanse. For 10 days, individuals consume a liquid diet consisting of lemon juice, cayenne pepper, maple syrup, and water. And then there's the Water Fast. During a water fast, individuals consume only water for a period of time, usually between 1 to 3 days, and it could be longer. What about supplements? Well, when it comes to supplementation and fasting, branched-chain amino acids and a multivitamin can provide some additional support without interfering with the fast itself. Branched-chain amino acids can help prevent muscle breakdown, especially after exercise. And although uncommon, with a well-planned diet, multivitamins can help prevent any nutrient deficiencies that may arise as a result of caloric restriction. Supplementing with electrolytes like sodium, magnesium, and potassium can help maintain hydration and prevent electrolyte imbalances and support proper body functioning, like muscle contractions, nerve impulses, and blood pressure. Other nutrients that could be considered include B vitamins, antioxidants, and liver support nutrients. If you have experience with fasting, please, by all means, like our post and comment below because we're going to keep this conversation going. And for more information about fasting and its clinical applications, visit Fullscript's Practitioner Medical Education Hub at www.fullscript.com/HCP.